Welcome to the Cyclone Tour Demo video. My name is Mark Findhammer, and in the next few minutes I'll give you a short demonstration of some of the features of the Cyclone tool. We start with opening a PNML file containing a quite simple PetriNet. The PetriNet is displayed in the left part of the GUI, and the computed coverability graph of the net is displayed in the right part. The node with the initial marking is highlighted yellow. First, we disable the automatic layout of the coverability graph, so that we can arrange some of its nodes more clearly. Now, it is easy to see that the coverability graph contains two closed paths, this one and this one. However, if we want to determine stop transitions, we have to search for non-decreasing closed paths. Remember that a closed path is called non-decreasing if the involved transitions have no negative effect for the token count of each place. So we can walk this path round and round without running out of tokens, so to speak. Let us see now how we can employ the Cyclone tool to determine stop transitions. First, we want to find out if transition E stops the net. So we select transition E with a left mouse click. Such a selected transition is also called a forbidden transition, since it is considered to be forbidden to occur infinitely often. Look at the little red-white prohibition sign put on the transition. This gives an intuitive hint that this transition is not absolutely forbidden to occur, but it is forbidden to occur in, let's say, infinite cyclic activities. By pressing the compute button, we start the algorithmic computation and get the immediate result that transition E does not stop the net. So transition E isn't a stop transition. This means that even if we forbid transition E to occur infinitely often, the net does not terminate necessarily, because there is still an infinite occurrence sequence which doesn't rely on transition E. The output of Cyclone also presents a reason for this result. A strongly connected solution has been found which doesn't contain transition E. Such a strongly connected solution corresponds directly to a specific closed path, which is highlighted green in the coverability graph, and has two necessary properties. First, this closed path is non-decreasing, and second, it has no edge labeled by transition E. Note that the transitions involved in the green path in the coverability graph are also highlighted green in the PetriNet. By clicking a node of the coverability graph, the particular marking is displayed in the PetriNet. That is, the respective number of tokens is displayed on each place of the net. This allows us to click several nodes one by one and retrace the corresponding markings in the net. In this way, we can conveniently study the cyclic behavior of the net. Next, we want to know if transition A stops the net. So we deselect transition E and select transition A instead. Again, we press the compute button, and this time we get the result that transition A indeed stops the net. So the algorithmic computation has shown that every non-decreasing closed path contains an edge labeled by transition A. Even though there is a closed path which doesn't involve transition A, this path is in fact decreasing, because transition D decreases the tokens on place P3. Therefore, this closed path doesn't lead to an infinite occurrence sequence. Cyclone also allows to select multiple transitions at once. Here we select transitions C, D, and E, since we want to know if forbidding these transitions simultaneously will stop the net. After pressing the compute button, we get the result that even forbidding these transitions simultaneously doesn't stop the net. Admittedly, this result doesn't really surprise, since we've already seen that there exists a strongly connected solution which doesn't involve any of these transitions. Cyclone also features some sort of batch processing. After pressing the compute all button, Cyclone automatically determines for each transition of the net whether or not it's a stop transition. The computed result informs us that transitions A and B are indeed stop transitions, whereas transitions C, D, and E don't stop the net, since a strongly connected solution exists for each of these transitions. Now let's open another PetriNet file. We select transition C as forbidden transition and press the compute button. The computed results informs us that transition C stops the net. Nevertheless, a basis solution has been determined. However, this basis solution isn't strongly connected, since the corresponding edges don't form a closed path. So there is no strongly connected solution, that is, there is no non-decreasing closed path without transition C, and therefore transition C indeed stops the net. Next, we forbid transition A instead and start the computation. This time, the output informs us that transition A doesn't stop the net, and that there are even six basis solutions, with four of them being strongly connected. All basis solutions are also listed in the lower right area of the GUI. Each strongly connected basis solution is highlighted green, whereas red indicates that a basis solution isn't strongly connected. We can select each basis solution in the list, and the corresponding edges are highlighted in the respective color. We can also select multiple basis solutions at once, and Cyclone determines on the fly if this combination of basis solutions is strongly connected or not. For example, selecting these two basis solutions together, the corresponding edges are highlighted green to indicate that this combination is strongly connected. However, if we additionally select another basis solution, the corresponding edges are highlighted red, because together these basis solutions aren't strongly connected. In this way, we can try out different combinations of basis solutions and get a visual feedback whether or not the respective combination is strongly connected. Next, we open a slightly more complex PetriNet to demonstrate another interesting feature of our tool. Cyclone also allows us to ask a more general version of our original question. Instead of asking if all transitions of the whole net are stopped, we can also ask if all transitions from a certain part of the net are stopped. In this example, we want to know if transition C stops the subnet consisting of transitions A and B. Therefore, we click on transition A and B while holding down the Shift key. So these transitions become labeled with a yellow OR lettering. After pressing the Compute button, we get a result which consists of an overall number of 18 basis solutions. Since these basis solutions aren't easy to identify in the much too crowded coverability graph, we press the Reduce Coverability Graph to Basis button. This removes all those edges and nodes of the coverability graph which are not relevant with respect to the computed set of basis solutions. We manually arrange the reduced coverability graph a little bit to get a clearer view of its nodes and edges. The computed result informs us that transition C doesn't stop all transitions of the subset consisting of transitions A and B. This is due to the fact that there exists a strongly connected solution, which doesn't contain transition C, but contains at least transition A or B. Note that in this case it even contains transitions A and B. The two basis solutions forming the strongly connected solution are selected in the list, and the corresponding edges are highlighted green in the coverability graph. Note that the strongly connected solution consists of two basis solutions, one which is strongly connected and another one which isn't strongly connected itself. However, the combination of these two basis solutions is indeed strongly connected. Note that this particular combination of basis solutions is the only combination which satisfies all our requirements. That is, it doesn't contain transition C, it contains at least transition A or B, and it is strongly connected. So altogether, it corresponds to a non-decreasing closed path which doesn't contain C, but contains A or B. Thank you for watching this demonstration of the Cyclone tool.